Hello, hello, ladies and gentlemen, your beloved Viggoman here, and welcome back to some more ViggoCraft. How are you guys doing? I hope you're doing great. I know I am. Always super stoked for... Was that a skeleton? Hello, right there? There's several of them. I can hear so many. Come on now. Come on, guy. Where's the other one? I don't know. I don't freaking know. I'm always stoked for some more ViggoCraft, my favorite series on the YouTubes. Today we are going to do something epic. Oh, hello there. There's another one. I don't want him to shoot me though. Let's get out of here. Oh, hero. Maybe we'll take him down, shall we? Come on, guy. Yeah, my favorite series on the YouTube. Today we're going to do a lot of crazy work together. Are you freaking ready? We're going to build an iron farm. My very first iron farm in Minecraft ever. So I'm super stoked. I think I have a design in mind, the very basic one, but we'll like do it twice or three times, whatever, to make it a little bit more efficient, and we'll build it over at the spawn chunks. So this is the spawning area where all the spawn chunks are, so this is where we're going to build the iron farm. And why so, Viggoman, you may ask? Well, let me tell you, if you didn't know, spawn chunks are always loaded. Wherever you are in the world, the spawn chunks will be loaded. Even if you're in the nether, these areas around here, you can see I've set up a small T over there of some smooth stone, and that is like the border from like in this direction, and I haven't measured out the border here, border over there, and that one. Basically, it's a 12 by 12 chunks area, I do believe, which are always loaded. That makes it so that we can make, for example, an iron farm, which we are going to do today, which will run always. Continuously just keep on running, producing big quantities of iron, which is something we will definitely need for this awesome base we're building right now. We're going to do a lot of hopper chains and redstone businesses, so we need some iron. So what I've done in between episode is just planning out a little bit here. So this is the size of the iron farm we're going for. We're going to have some water streams like here, and they like just touches the edge here. So basically, these iron golems will make use of the iron golem spawning by... Oh, no, crap. Stupid Viggo. we're going to use the mechanic for iron golem spawning. We'll have some villagers up here. I need to bring those over, which will be a freaking pain. We'll have 10 villagers on each layer here. And then at least 21 doors. That's like how the Minecraft game code calculates it. So if, do I have any, no, I could actually just start a little bit. Wow, words today. My thong is not really collaborating with me. But anyway, I think I have a chest somewhere. Yeah, there we go. With some smooth stone. So yeah, how Minecraft works is that if an area has 21 doors or more, and 10 villagers, they will spawn an iron golem in the middle. So this area here, when we're getting this all done, we should have some iron golem spawning in the water here, and we'll have a second layer of water streams they will spawn on. They will fall into this hole in the middle, and we'll have a lava pitch. They will burn to death, and we'll have some hoppers picking up all the jazz. And for this to work, you need to make each of this farm, each individual farm, 70 blocks away from each other, so you don't interrupt the spawning rates. So what I want to do is to make one right here, and then 70 blocks up in the air, we'll add another one. So we have two layers at least. I don't know if we can manage to squeeze in another one on top of that. And we'll use the same burning chamber here just to make it a little bit more efficient, I guess. So why don't I just crack on with some building. A lot of building, actually. A couple of hours of building and stuff. You might see a small bit of a time lapse or cinematic, I don't really know. And I'll be right back with you. So So that is one part done, the first part done. We still have 10 more villagers we need to move up. We have another one of these bad boys need to build 70 blocks up in the air. That takes me about another hour to do. So let's just crack on. There we go. Two identical parts of iron spawners placed directly above each other. That makes it so the iron golems will spawn up here. They will fall down and land on this one, then get taken down to, I don't know if you saw in the time lapse, but there is lava in here somewhere. Maybe I think I can break this block. Yeah, you can see there's some lava. Iron golems will be dragged with water streams falling down here, being burnt to death by the lava. These hoppers will pick up the iron and get into here. We have 22 iron ingots already and a few poppies. So iron golems apparently drop poppies as well. I want to make some kind of sorting filter here, item sorter, to get rid of all the poppies, because I don't really need the poppies. Poppies are ugly, poppies are stupid, they're girly stuff. We're mans over here, we're like really muscular, masculine guys here, so we don't want the flowers, do we? So I think we might wanna build some kind of sorting system to sort out the poppies and burn them, I think is the easiest way. Oh, there we go, another one just died. Did he drop any more? Yeah. Oh, that sound real scared me, that's so loud though. Oh, poor guy. Oh, and he's dead in any second now. There we go. That is some loud shit. So it's pretty efficient, actually. It hasn't been running for too long, and we all already have half a stack of iron. So I imagine when this is just constantly running, while we're over at our base working and stuff, we should have a fair amount of iron here in the end. Alright, I'm back over at the sanctuary, the stronghold, whatever you want to call it. I'm not sure yet. I think I'm falling for the sanctuary, because it feels awesome or more awesome. Let me know what you think down below. I'm here to pick up a little bit of redstone, a little bit of jazz and all this stuff to get ready to set up a small item sorting system. I don't think I have done anything to the base since the last time you guys were around together with me. I'm actually recording this part right here on the Tuesday, so almost a week before this video comes out, and just a few days after the last video came out. So basically, I haven't been able to do much, but I started recording early on this week, because I know that this project will take freaking forever. But one thing I did was to capture this guy while separate him from the group, because look at this, we have sharpness 4. That's pretty good, can get sharpness 5 from that, and I don't think that's too expensive. And then we have infinity right here, that is pretty cool. And what else do we have? We have one of these bad boys, this one? No. And one of these sells a fortune tree pickaxe, or fortune tree book like that, which I have put on my pickaxe, Picasso, which is the name I've been going for my pickaxes for a while now. So we have a fortune tree, unbreaking tree, using the enchantment area we made last episode. Alright, we're back at the iron farm. I've crafted up some redstone stuff. All we need, I do believe, I really hope so, I don't want to run back all the way again. Even though I have a nether portal set up, so it's not that far of a ride or a walk. But yeah, I think we have everything set up. So what I want to do, I'll try to explain everything to you, is that I want to have something coming out from this hopper here. This is where the iron comes from the farm. And we'll have an item sorter sorting out all of the iron so that we can get iron down to a row of chests where we will be storing it while we're not over here picking it up. So while we're working other parts of the area, this area will still be loaded. We'll be getting tons upon tons of iron, hopefully. So we'll have a lot of storage for those. And then we'll have another, like, row of hoppers going into a dropper with some redstone magic happening and then some lava. And we're gonna burn up all the poppies and all the stuff we don't really want. So what we want to do, I don't really know. I'll try to do it on camera here. If I place you right there, no, that might be a problem. I might need to think loud here a little bit. I don't really know how I would go on with this project here. But if I place... Oh, there's another one dying. Poor guy. Okay, I think I have an idea right now. If I place this facing into here... That is so loud. Be quiet, man. Like there, and then we have one going into there, one going into there, like that. Break you again. So, basically, the hopper row leads into this dropper here. We can see all the iron in here. I'll take that. Put you in here. Hero guy. Stupid idiot. There we go. So what I want to do is to take out all of the iron. Guys, stop it. Please. Friendly creature. Are you a friendly creature? Yeah, there we go. That's much better. I'm gonna take out, separate all the iron out, put them down into some chests, and the poppies will get into here and shoot them out to lava, which is supposed to be right here. I think that should be fairly simple. So let's see if I can actually do this here on camera. What I want to do is place a hopper into here like that, and then I want to place alright, let's see, chest like that, and a hopper into that one like that should be okay, I guess. And then we need to just rearrange a little bit here. I hope this won't interrupt with the hopper stuff up here, but I think it should be okay. Because we need to make an item sorter, a very simple one. I'm going for impulses as V's design here for doing this. Also, if I didn't mention, the iron farm design I'm using is from 100% Awesome on YouTube. I know many people have done this before him, but I followed his tutorial to make this. Okay, so what we want to do is to... Alright, there we go. 1, 2, 3, and then a block, free block there, and then, no, there we go, I think. We'll have, this one might be a little bit derpy here, because I suck at doing redstone on camera, but you guys just have to bear with me. We'll have a comparator right here, which will send out a redstone signal whenever the stuff in here. We'll have some redstone dust laying on top here like that, with a repeater facing into this block with a torch on it, a redstone torch, like that. So now this hopper here should be locked. Let's test that. It is locked. Perfecto mundo. That makes it so that items coming in here will not go down here unless we go sleep first really quickly. I don't want creepers to blow up my beautiful creation here. Is it not nighttime? It's very soon, very soon. Until there's enough items in this hopper here to power the redstone signal 3 times, okay? So like the power of 3 coming out of this comparator here, 1, 2, 3. Then the repeater will be powered, the redstone torch will go up. This won't be unlocked, items can flow through and into here. All the way until we have not enough items to keep it powered anymore. Let's sleep now, shall we? So, it's a very simple design actually, and it's really cool, very efficient, and super smart actually. I'm just like impressed of people getting figuring out stuff like that. So what we might want to do, we need some items. We're not expecting to get through the filter. Maybe some seeds. I like to use seeds. I've done that in several of my other sorting systems, just because you don't really get seeds from anything. Did I hear something? No, I don't know. I'm hearing stuff. I should be worried. And then we'll take 41. I do believe that's the exact number, actually, until it starts counting here. So if I place you in there, nothing happens. Alright, alright, alright. But if I now place an iron in here, one iron... Oh! Oh, that's cool. That is cool. Okay, let's try again. Place an iron in here. It should go down here. No. What the crap? Where did that go? In here? Okay, I've done something wrong, I do believe. Why is it not working? That is one good question, Viggo. Okay, it goes in here. It should go down here. There we go. It go down. Yeah, look at that. And hopefully nothing should end up in the dropper here, because if that happens, we are basically burning... We're burning items, or ingots, iron ingots, whatever. Oh man, I'm getting derpy right now. It's getting late. And there we go, it's filtering through. That is awesome. That means it works. So what I want to do is just clear out a little bit more area here, because I have two more hoppers. That means we can squeeze in two more double chests of storage here, which I need to craft and all the stuff. But I hope that my small explanation of how the item sort of works was a little bit helpful, and that you guys perhaps have a better understanding of how it works if you haven't had it already. Some of the Minecraft stuff is just really freaking hard to understand. So I'm always appreciating people who explain what they do in their videos. And today I was one of them explaining. Okay, coming on here. Let's see, if I put them down there, everything goes down to this one. Very, very cool. Now it's time for us to be really annoyed by the door sounds. No, to actually make this item destroyer thingy stuffy. If we manage to just like squeeze this in a little bit here like this. I'll try to explain a little bit as well here, because I like doing that, you know. And then go back and into here. Subtract. So basically what happens here, whenever there's an item inside here, I think it should be working. Yeah, there we go. Everything is dropped out here. So whenever there's an item in here, this one gets a signal. This one repeats it to like full strength, so that this one gets a signal. Send this over to here, which will turn this off again, because it gets a power from this side, which then like sends a signal to here, like, yeah, very like quick pulsed stuff going over here, shooting them out. And what we will do is place some lava right here. Items we don't want, like the puppies, will be burnt in the lava. Anyway, I want to make this area look a little bit better here. I don't want it to look this industrial, derpy, ugly stuff with exposed redstone and all the stuff. So what I want to do is just create a small room here like this, something like that, and then we'll have the portal in the end here, I guess. Have moved the portal to over here, and we just have a small room basically. We can come in and pick up some iron. We don't really need much more than that. Do we want to make it look fancy though? That is the question. It could be pretty cool to make it look super fancy. Let's throw out something here. If I remove you, and remove all this stuff here, we can try to do something a little bit cool. Raising this up here, of course, and then... Because I want to make stuff look a little bit pretty, if I have the time and put in the effort. So, I have a small idea for what might look cool right here. Keeping the same color pattern as over at the sanctuary. There we go. And then let's make some pillars. Like that. And... Okay, so we'll have to take a look here on how that actually looks. That's not too bad. I think I might want to do that for the other part as well here, to just keep it symmetrical. The freaking villagers though, I might have to kill some of them, because they make so much sound. There. Yeah, that's not too bad. That's not too bad. Let's make some slabs as well while we're at it. Like that. And place them here and there, I think. And then maybe put some buttons on. Oh, interesting stuff. Things get tricky. Yeah, that looks cool, I think. Yeah, I like the feeling of this area right here. We want to make it a little bit taller though, so let's add another layer of quartz like that. Stairs, let's make stairs quickly. Viggo, stairs, come on guy. Let's make some stairs here to place above the chests here, so that we actually can open the top chest if we ever fill up the bottom ones. So do something like this. And what should we do for the roof? Do we want to go red? That is a question. And I think the answer is, let's try it out. Derp. Let's try it out with red. I don't really know. I'm not a big fan of big plane surfaces like this, but it might actually work in this case. Oh, yeah, that is pretty cool. And if I do something like this, just to make it look a little bit more detailed. Oh, yeah, I like that one. Absolutely. I'm starting to really like this small room right here, with the chest and with the cool color scheme as we used on the base. And a portal here, and I tried to use some acacia here on the floor, and I really think it fits in perfectly, because it has like this more of a pale orange feeling to it, so it kind of stands in the middle of the orange and the quartz, and it really looks cool in here. Oh, I screwed up. But that doesn't matter, because I was going to break those blocks anyway, because I want to plan out a little bit here, tell you a little bit about the plans I have, and maybe let you guys come with suggestions. Because this is a spawn chunk, so basically I want to have this as a big open industrial area for farms. We don't want to have close to our base, and we'll just be like going on AFKable, kind of. They will keep on going wherever I am, if that's the case, or we could have some farms we need to be over here to make them work with all the stuff. But just to keep it like this area here, filled up with farms we don't want to have close to our base, and which is really necessary to have a big like farming industrial area around here. I think that should be cool. So I don't really want to care about the looks of the outside of stuff, because we're not going to see much of the outside here. We're just going to get over here, bring back all the resources we need, or perhaps build some new farms, but then go back to our sanctuary and live there happily. So yeah, this area looks really ugly. The farm looks really ugly, but I don't want to bother with doing fancy stuff around here, because I'm not going to be living over here much. Just going to get over here, grab some materials, resources, and all the stuff, and then get back home to the sanctuary. And if I decide to go around here, I think I should be able to live anyway. Cause yeah, I've played with bad Minecrafters, and I've learned to live with them as well. But I think that is all I got time for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I really do hope you enjoyed. If so, be sure to smack that like button. And if you haven't done already, be sure to subscribe and all that stuff. And I will see you all guys later. It's been Viggoman, and I'm out.